Hi everyone, welcome to our presentation for LDSP, Shopping with Cryptocurrency Privately and Quickly Under Leadership. I'm Lu Xuan, from the Department of Information Engineering, the Chinese University of Hong Kong. Nowadays, shopping with cryptocurrency may give you an unsatisfying experience because it is slow. For example, it takes an hour to confirm a Bitcoin transaction. Also, the spending history is exploited on the blockchain. Layer 2 networks aims to reduce the payment confirmation time. Basically, the payer and payee confirm the payment off-chain by co-signing on a balance sheet and update it on-chain later. However, its first issue is that the payer needs to lock money for a single payee, which will be sizable if he has many potential payees. On the other hand, the payer and payee need to constantly online to prevent each other uploading an outdated balance sheet. Finally, the privacy issue is not solved because the total transaction amount and who paid to whom is exploded on the blockchain. Snappy is a layer 2 solution tailor-made for retail. In this payment system, the user is either a customer or a merchant. As a layer 2 solution, it has slow payment confirmation time. The customers need not to monitor the blockchain because the merchants, as payees, has little incentive to upload an outdated balance sheet. Also, a customer can lock less money because the collateral is usable for many merchants. However, Snappy still suffers from the privacy issue that the customer's spending history is revealed to all merchants. This issue stems from the core design of Snappy that a customer needs to reveal the payments to the majority of merchants so that they can get the attestation for payment confirmation. Here, we propose LDSP, a layer 2 anonymous payment system with a bunch of advantages. Firstly, a payment in LDSP can be done within seconds. LDSP also allows the merchants to join and leave dynamically, and the customer can pay multiple merchants. LDSP is scalable in a sense that the on-chain operational costs reduce through patching. Most importantly, LDSP achieves payer privacy, which means the payer's identity is hidden in a payment. Moreover, the payment's amount is obfuscated by discrete coin values. Now, let's briefly introduce the core entities in LDSP. First, we have customers who want to pay merchants off-chain. A consortium formed by a group of merchants, a leader for the consortium, and an arbiter instantiated by a smart contract. One of its main duties is to resolve disputes. In LDSP, a customer needs to first withdraw LDSP coins by funding them with on-chain coins, and then it can spend the LDSP coin off-chain to merchants. If it decides not to spend the remaining LDSP coins, it can refund them for on-chain coins. Finally, the merchants can bookkeep and then deposit their received LDSP coins to get on-chain coins. Now, let's talk about one of the central issues LDSP aiming to solve, which is who issue LDSP coins. If issuing coins require an agreement by all merchants, the time-consuming communication among them make it not scalable. If only one merchant is needed, it may become a money printing factory and spend this fake money at victim merchants. If a large subset of the merchant is needed, it seems like the worst of both worlds. Or, is it? A main idea of LDSP is introducing the leaders. Each of them leads a group of merchants to form a virtual bank. The merchants in a virtual bank jointly issue coins. The coins can be spent at the issuing merchants or pay merchants in another bank, by which we can perform cross-group payments. The leaders will take care of cross-group payment internally. Besides that, a leader needs to confirm every payment in this group to prevent double spending. Being a leader can give its extra benefits, like getting service fees and building a partnership with other merchants and leaders. Here are some highlights of LDSP. Even a small group size of virtual bank, the coin issuing time remains reasonable. The merchants also the gatekeeper of the virtual banks, which means they seek consensus on which merchants gets back how many LDSP coins. Also, our merchants can belong to multiple virtual banks. As the merchants will be the payees of the coin, they have no incentive to forge coins. In LDSP, the merchants can join or leave a virtual bank or even the entire system. LDSP can grow up and be mature gradually. As we mentioned before, LDSP supports interbank transaction, which in a way leverages the business relationship among merchants to benefit their customers. If a merchant knows a virtual bank well, it should be fine with accepting coins from that bank. In contrast, if it's not familiar with that bank, it may need more confirmations before receiving their coins. From the customer's perspective, the coins from a virtual bank is like the points or mileages in our customer loyalty program. If they frequently spend at some shops, they may get more coins for these shops, and vice versa. The LDSP coins are basically branching share from a group. We may consider this design trading a bit privacy of the customers for better efficiency of the system. In the following, we will dive deeper into our protocols. First, let's talk about how a customer withdraws our LDSP coin. The customer generates a random serial number SN and uploads a hash of it to the arbiter after binding. The merchants then jointly sign on the hash and upload the bind signature. The customer unblind it and get the signatures as an LDSP coin. This multi-blind signature approach helps achieve pair privacy because the blinding hides the linkage between the on-chain coins and the LDSP coins. The customers are hidden among those spending coins from the same virtual bank. During an off-chain payment, the customer reveals the hash and the signature pair to the merchants and the leader. Once the leader confirms it, the customer can reveal the serial number to close the deal. When a customer wants to refund, it uploads the opening for the blind the hash of SN. If the LDSP coin is banned, the customer can upload SN to debunk this refund. If there's no dispute, the customer gets back an on-chain coin. In merchant bookkeeping, the leader uploads the merchant's payment records in patch after letting the merchant sign on it. This protocol will be invoked periodically to check if the leaders approve double spending. At the end, the merchants can deposit their book cap coins at once. In LDSP, customers will not lose money because they can always refund their unspent LDSP coins. Merchants' money is also safe because the merchants can ask for compensation if the leader approves double spending, and no coin can be forged without its signature. According to our experiments, a customer can pay up to 512 coins within half a second under urban network condition. We also implement the Aptor as a smart contract on Ethereum to measure the on-chain operational cost. With our patching techniques, restoring or refunding a coin takes less than 40 gas, which is much cheaper than the 21,000 gas needed for a normal transaction in Ethereum. To sum up, LDSP enables customers to spend crypto coins quickly and privately, working under a dynamic and distributed system with scalable on-chain process. There's a lot we haven't covered in this presentation. For example, the mechanism to reduce on-chain costs, a way to achieve lower collaterals, the analysis on LDSP safety and liveness, and how we prevent single point of failure by the leader. We encourage you to check out our paper. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us. Thank you.